I'll read from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if Christ is preached as raised from the dead, how can some among you say there is no resurrection of the dead? If the dead are not raised, neither has Christ been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, your faith is vain. You are still in your sins. Then those who have fallen asleep in Christ have perished. If for this life only we have hoped in Christ, we are the most pitiable people of all. But now Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
strength in flesh, whose heart turns away from the Lord. He is like a barren bush in the desert, enjoys no change of season, but stands in a lava waste, a salt and empty earth. Blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose hope is the Lord. He is like a tree planted beside the waters that stretches out its roots to the stream. It fears not the heat when it comes, its leaves stay green. In a year of drought, it shows no stress, but still bears fruit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Himself is kind to the ungrateful and to the wicked. So just so you know, I would never send you an email asking for money for my stuff or for 100 iTunes cards, which is some of the craziness that they ask. And if you really get an email from somebody asking, oh, I'm desperately, help me, check where it's coming from. You'll find that it's not their email address. It's a false email address. So, there are snakes. There are evil people. There are people who do evil. Jesus is telling us, hate the sin, but love the sinner. Why? Because we are all sinners. Now, we can become outraged at the sins of others. Who is not outraged by the sin of the church? Or those in the church. See, with all of this focus and attention on sins of the past, horrific, terrible things, remember the difference between what we believe and how people behave. There is absolutely nothing false or wrong about what we believe as Catholic Christians. The sacraments are true. Jesus is not a liar. He's our Savior. And what we believe as Catholic Christians is the absolute truth. How some of us behave, that's the problem. And that is always that problem. Human behavior, the reality of sin. And it's everywhere and touches everyone. But it's interesting that the gospel reminds us tonight, be careful about how severe you are in your judgment. I'm sure you heard the phrase, my mother always said it, there but by the grace of God go on. It's very easy for us to get on our high horse and judge from someone else. And when we see evil parading for us in the news, what does the Lord ask us to do? Pray for that person. That sorry, miserable wretch who committed that awful crime. To pray for them. How hard it is to pray for our enemies and for those who abuse and neglect us. There's a story that Jesus was going past one of these towns, and as the gospel reports, the people there despised him. They told him to leave. And Jesus returned a blessing and kept going. And his disciples asked him, Lord, how can we bless those who persecute you? And he said, I can only give what is in my purse. What's in your wallet? Not the wallet of your financial well-being, but in your heart. We can only give what we possess. So if we possess deep inside anger, hatred, violence, that is how we will react to every another. But if you and I can come to possess the Spirit of God, The church needs to be purified. And in every age, she has been. Read our history. Purification is necessary. Because of all this scrutiny, children and everyone is far safer in the Catholic Church than anywhere else. But at the same time, there are many other institutions and places that are not receiving the same charity, and perhaps aren't nearly as safe. So how should we react? As the Lord told us in the Gospel, with compassion, love, mercy, forgiveness, but also to look in the mirror. For we are all sinners in need of a Savior. Jesus said, I am the vine, you are the branches. Apart from him, we can do nothing. With him, we can do all things. So what's in your wallet? The love of God, the grace to persevere, the trust to believe, to return a blessing instead of violence. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for our sin and for our salvation.
Witness to God's mercy and love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
those in public office, that they may be open to God's grace and work to protect the weak and vulnerable in their midst. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and the lonely, that for the love and compassion of others, they may know God's unfailing presence in their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Lord inspire in our hearts both great and small acts of love that support and encourage our sisters and brothers as
so the whole company of choirs and angels, we praise you with joy as we are playing.
Grant also to